Hello friends, welcome to Share Market Friend again. Today I am going to cover 5 to 6 important points and interesting points about LIQUIDBEES. Basically, LIQUIDBEES, that is popularly known as, is actually open-ended Reliance LIQUIDBEES fund. It invests in basically credit related instruments. So it is basically a debt mutual fund. Why people prefer, or why I like this LIQUIDBEES, is that it has no entry or exit charge, and it is very easy to invest and withdraw like FD itself. Okay, we can invest idle cash into it, or if you have emergency fund with you, you can invest into it. It runs with T plus 2 rolling settlement. So if you invest into it, you will get 2 days to get units into your account, or if you withdraw it, you will need to wait for 2 days for to get money into your account. It is very easy to operate through demat account, though you can directly invest Reliance mutual fund website or into this without demat account itself, just by verifying you are doing your KYC, etc. Also, there's one thing to mention is that there is a limit of 50,000 per day withdrawal into LIQUIDBEES. It is put in by SEBI. That is what I understood. Okay. And second point I would like to cover is this. Okay. It is about what actually LIQUIDBEES invests in. It actually invests in various T-bills or certificate of deposits. Those has maturity up to 91 days, that is around 3 months of maturity. So beyond that date of maturity, papers it doesn't invest in, and SEBI also mandates it not to invest into it into that after the reclassification of debt funds. It gives return of around 6 to 8%. It does vary from 6 to 6, 7 or 8% or 8.5% sometimes also. So that is one thing. There is one benefit of investing into LIQUIDBEES is that if you come into high income bracket, so your FD interest will be charged at around 20 to 30%. So if you invest in LIQUIDBEES and if you stay for 3 years and more, then your overall taxation reduces even below 10% also sometimes. Okay. So the gains from LIQUIDBEES, if you sell before 3 years, they're treated as short-term capital gain, as it is a debt fund, and if you sell it after 3 years, then it is treated as long-term capital gain. For below 3 years gains, that gains will be added to your income, and it will be charged according to your income tax. Okay, and if you are above, if you are investing above for 3 years, then it is long-term capital gain, and you will get 20% tax rate with indexation benefit and 10% without indexation benefit. Okay, one point I skipped here, and that was this. The benefit of investing into LIQUIDBEES compared to FD is that when interest rates are on higher end, what that is happening right now due to credit crunch and all those things. So in that case, you may find that LIQUIDBEES are not that return producing instrument. But if you stay into it for longer term, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, whatever, and in the meantime, if interest rates goes down, then in FD, you will keep getting the same current rate of interest rate or whatever is stipulated by bank at that time. But in this portfolio, this plus point that this fund keeps churning their portfolio with 91 days paper. So every 3 months there, most of the papers get replaced. That is what I understood. So because of that, you get interest rate of fresh or present high yielding papers. So that is one benefit into it. So if you invest for longer period, or above 1 year, 2 year, etc., then you can get better returns compared to FD. That is what I understood. Also, there is one risk of credit into it, as they invest in credit related instruments like commercial papers, T-bills of government, etc. So they have risk of credit into it, because recently there was issue of bankruptcy related to Island FS and all. So a lot of SPVs, etc., those issued bonds by Island FS, they were defaulted on their interest. So due to that, few liquid funds reported loss of NAV of 6 to 7, 8% in a single day. So that was a risk into it. But for LIQUIDBEES, the investment is varied into various and number of papers and commercial papers. So I don't think that is that much risky. That is what my personal opinion it is. So please refer my disclosure before taking any decision based on this information. Also, I would like to show what this Reliance LIQUIDBEES fund basically has in its asset. This is a website of Reliance Mutual Fund. If you want to invest into it, you can directly visit to it. In that, I opened the fact sheet where it shows the asset or portfolio of up to 31st December 2008. Actually, it keeps changing. So it is a portfolio on date of 31st December 2018. I will show you the basic breakup. It contains around 4% of bills rediscounting, then 43% around certificate of deposit like Vijaya Bank, IDFC Bank Limited, Axis Bank Limited, etc. Then it has around 48% commercial paper, those of Reliance Jio, Infocom Limited 7%, Vedanta Limited 4.5%, National Housing Bank 2.5%, and many more other private companies who has issued highly rated paper. So I don't think that is a cause of worry right now. That is what I think. Then there is 4.5% percentage around that of corporate bonds issued by Housing Development Finance Corporation Limited, Power Finance Corporation Limited, LIC Housing Finance Limited. Also, it has 2.5% of state government bonds, securities, treasury bills around 6.5%. So the overall LIQUIDBEES investment can be classified into three parts, that is treasury bill of 6.5%, then corporate bond 5% around, commercial paper and certificate of deposit occupy the 80 to 90% of the part. So that was all about LIQUIDBEES. If you liked it, you can click on the like. Thank you very much for listening. Share Market Friend.